Welcome back to Chemistry Matters and our study of solutions. Solutions often possess different properties than the solvent by itself would possess. For example, properties such as boiling point and freezing point are different for pure water than they are for salt water. We've all seen footage of winter storms with trucks putting salt on the road. This is because the salt will lower the freezing point of pure water and make the roads safer for cars. Salt water will also boil at a higher temperature than pure water by itself would. These are two examples of what we call colligative properties. Colligative properties are properties of a solution that are different than those of a pure solvent by itself. These properties are also dependent on the concentration of the solute particles, not just their identity. There are four types of colligative properties, but the two types we'll explore in this unit are freezing point depression and boiling point elevation. In order to calculate colligative properties, we'll need to look at a third way to describe how concentrated a solution is, molality, which is abbreviated with a lowercase m. The word molality looks and sounds a lot like molarity, but there's an important distinction between the two. While both expressions have moles of solute written in the numerator, molarity has volume of the solution in liters in the denominator, whereas molality has kilograms of solvent in the denominator. Since both moles and mass do not change with temperature, molality, unlike molarity, is not temperature dependent. So we'll use this measure of concentration when we study solutions at varying temperatures. The reason molarity can change slightly if an experiment is run at multiple temperatures is because the volume of the solution can change with temperature. As a solution cools, the volume can constrict slightly. As the temperature increases, the volume can expand slightly. This concept is called thermal expansion, and it's why engineers have to place joints in roads when they build our highways. Anytime a substance is heated, there's thermal expansion. In other words, the volume that it occupies increases. The same thing happens when a solution is heated. The volume that it occupies will increase. That's why chemists have this third way to express the concentration of solutions. Chemists will use molality to express concentration when running experiments at widely varying temperatures. Molality is also used in calculations when we're investigating colligative properties and the effects that various solutes have on the properties of solutions, such as freezing point depression and boiling point elevation. Freezing point depression is a colligative property that describes how the freezing point of a solution is lowered compared to the freezing point of the pure solvent. Boiling point elevation occurs when the boiling point of a solution is higher than the boiling point of the pure solvent alone. The amount that a solution's freezing point or boiling point can be altered can be calculated with a formula. We'll learn about that formula in just a bit, but first, let's get out to our classroom for some practice investigating colligative properties that I'm pretty sure you're going to like.
For this activity, we're actually going to conduct a delicious investigation of colligative properties by creating some homemade ice cream. Colligative properties are properties of a solution, like the freezing point, that are different than what the property would be if it were just the solvent alone. For this activity, I'd like for you and your partner to follow the instructions I put on the monitor. Each team will place 1 cup of milk and 2 tablespoons of sugar and 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract into a plastic zipper bag. Get as much air out of the bag as possible and then seal it tightly. Move the contents of the bag around with your fingers until the sugar dissolves. Next, you're going to add some more crushed ice to the cylinder and add a generous amount of the salt. Then you'll take your plastic bag that's sealed and you'll add it on top of the ice. And then you'll add more ice and more salt. Once the ice is filled to the top, you're gonna close the jar and make sure that it's sealed. Okay, so you'll roll the jar on the table back and forth between the two of you until the mixture turns solid. This will become evident when air bubbles inside the plastic bag stop moving around. If too much ice melts inside the jar before that happens, add more ice and salt and then continue rolling it. Once you finish, open the jar, take out the bag, and scoop out of the contents of your ice cream, dividing it equally between the two of you. And then you get to enjoy the ice cream.
That's not bad.
Okay, now that you're all enjoying your solutions, let's attach some chemistry to what just happened. First of all, I'd like both teams to take a quick temperature reading of the salt, ice, and water solution that's still in your cylinders.
Well, that's weird. The freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius, but this is minus 12 and it's still going down.
Yeah, mine says negative 7.9 degrees Celsius. How is it still liquid water at that temperature?
Those are great observations, and that was really the whole point of this lab. You see, when solutes are dissolved into solvents, they alter the properties of the solvent. So when you dissolve the salt into the water, you essentially make it more difficult for the water molecules to come together to solidify into ice, because there are all these dissolved solute particles that are in the way. This means that the temperature of the water has to get colder than it normally would be so that it could freeze. So since you lowered the freezing point of the salt and water and ice mixture in the container, your milk and sugar and vanilla mixture froze.
What our students just got a taste of, aside from delicious ice cream, was a real-life example of how colligative properties work in solutions. We can do calculations to determine the degree to which freezing point or boiling point will be altered due to the presence of solute particles. And that's an important part of chemistry. The formula for calculating freezing point depression and boiling point elevation can be seen here. Delta T equals I times K times molality. As you can see, it requires three variables. Delta T represents the change in temperature in degrees Celsius, and it's by this amount that the freezing point will be lowered for the solution relative to the pure solvent alone. K is a constant that is dependent on the solvent being affected. These solvent constants are well known by chemists and are available in tables like the chart you can get in the Chemistry Matters Toolkit. So that part is easy. M represents molality. I represents the number of particles dissolved in the solution. Remember the models of sugar and salt dissolving our students drew earlier in this unit? Sugar, like other non-electrolyte covalent substances, will remain intact when dissolved, and so it will contribute one particle. If the substance is an electrolyte that will dissociate into ions when dissolved, like the salt, or NaCl our students drew, it has an I value of 2 for the two ions that formed. A salt, like sodium phosphate, is made of 4 ions, 3 sodiums and 1 phosphate, and will have an I value of 4. Similarly, for boiling point elevation, the formula would be the same, but you must use the boiling point solvent constant for K. You can get a chart for boiling point constants in the Chemistry Matters Toolkit as well. Let's head back to our classroom, where our students have finished their ice cream and are now getting some practice with colligative property calculations.
Okay, let's get started. Team 1, I'd like you to solve a practice problem involving boiling point elevation. So first, you're going to have a solution of 0.73 moles of glucose in 225 grams of phenol, and you'll figure out what the new boiling point of the phenol is. The boiling constant, or the KB, is 3.60 degrees Celsius per molal, and the normal boiling point of phenol is 182 degrees Celsius. Team 2, I want you guys to work on a freezing point depression calculation. Okay, so in your problem, you're going to find the freezing point of a saturated solution of sodium chloride, where you've got 28 grams of sodium chloride in 100 grams of water. The freezing constant, or the KF, is 1.86 degrees Celsius per molal. And as you know, the normal freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. So once you've finished your work on your whiteboards, we'll discuss it. Team 1, walk us through your calculations.
Okay, molality is moles of solute divided by kilograms of solvent In this case, we have 225 grams of solvent, phenol, which equals 0.225 kilograms. So 0.73 moles of glucose divided by 0.225 kilograms of phenol is 3.2 mol. And I is going to be 1 since the solute is glucose, which is a covalently bonded compound that stays as one molecule when it's dissolved. And from our chart, the boiling constant KB of phenol is 3.60 degrees Celsius per mol.
Very good.
Solving for delta T, we found an answer of 12 degrees Celsius, which means the boiling point of this solution would actually be 194 degrees Celsius, 12 degrees higher than what the normal boiling point of phenol alone would be, 182 degrees.
Outstanding. Team two, how does your freezing point depression problem go?
So we took 28 grams of salt and converted that to moles. We then divided that by the kilograms of solvent, which was the water. Since we had 100 milliliters and 100 milliliters of water is equivalent to 100 grams, we knew we had 0.1 kilograms of water.
We then divided the moles of salt by 0.1 kilogram and found the molality to be 4.8 molal. I in this case would be 2 since we have an ionic compound that's breaking up to form two ions in the solution. And from our chart, the freezing constant KF for water is 1.86 degrees Celsius per molal.
Very good catch there, noticing the ionic compound.
So solving for delta T, we found 18 degrees Celsius. And the freezing point of this solution would be negative 18 degrees Celsius, which is 18 degrees colder than the normal freezing point of pure water alone.
Great work, everyone. Sometimes these colligative property calculations are tricky. Remember, when you calculate your delta T, that's not your new temperature. It's just the amount by which the normal boiling or freezing point is changed. So you still have to subtract or add the number that you calculate for delta T from the freezing or the boiling point of the solvent alone. But nice work, everyone.
Indeed, some impressive work on colligative properties from our students. Now that we've spent some time on colligative properties, when you think back to the beginning of this unit, you'll understand why we chose the King of Pops to start things off. The pops that the King of Pops make are frozen, but they don't get as hard as pure ice because of the sugar and salt dissolved in the water of the pop mixture. The freezing point of the water is depressed by the sugar and salt, making the pop a more enjoyable texture and delicious. We'll take a break here so you can practice colligative property calculations and test your skills by making some ice cream of your own. You can find instructions for the Freezing Point Ice Cream Lab, as well as practice problems, in our Chemistry Matters Toolkit. And there's even a closer look video that can help. When you're ready, I'll see you at the top of the next video of the Unit 7 playlist, where we'll begin to investigate some extremely important classes of solutions, acids and bases. See you there.